प्लीज सब्सक्राइब टू गौरी ट्यूटोरियल्स यूट्यूब चैनल एंड प्रेस द बेल आइकन सो दैट यू कुड गेट द नोटिफिकेशन ऑफ न्यू वीडियोस एज द टाइम ऑफ अपलोड। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट द टंग एंड द टीथ। इन द लास्ट पार्ट वी स्टडीड अबाउट द हार्ड पैलेट एंड सॉफ्ट पैलेट इन द बक्कल कैविटी। नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी अबाउट द टंग। Now, what is tongue? Tongue is a thick musculosensory organ. Musculo means it has muscles, and sensory organ because it can sense the taste. Whatever food we have, it can taste it. It is present on the floor of buccal cavity. You can see this is the floor of buccal cavity. At this place, tongue is present and is attached to the floor of buccal cavity with a ligamentous fold. Matlab that fold is made up of ligament. And that is called as lingual frenulum. Lingual word is for tongue. So that fold which joins the tongue with the lower part of the buccal cavity, that is a filamentous fold. That is a ligamentous fold which is made up of ligament. It is called as lingual frenulum. Now there are presence of papillae on the tongue. They are of four kinds. Velate or circumvallate papillae. You can see here there are circumvallate papillae. They are larger in size. Then filiform papillae. These are the filiform papillae which you can see here. Then fungiform papillae. These are the fungiform papillae which are present on the tongue. And the foliate papillae. These are present on the sides like this. So these papillae, they contain the taste buds. And we are able to sense different tastes with the help of tongue only. And the taste buds, they are present on the papillae in the tongue. So the papillae, they bear the taste buds, and we can taste four basic tastes, that is sweet, salty, sour and bitter. We can taste these four tastes with the help of our tongue. And these are the areas where we can taste it. We can taste salty and sweet from this area, and the sour taste from these sides, and bitter taste from the back side of the tongue. And the papillae for same are present in the and the taste buds for these are present in the papillae, which are present on the tongue. And in the center there are not so many taste buds. Here the power of sensing the taste, that is quite less. Now a question comes to our mind that despite these, our tongue has these four kind of basic taste buds, but we are able to taste lot many things. Like in sweet, we have different kind of flavors which we can taste. So the reason is that our olfactory receptors, which are present in our nose, they also help us to taste a little bit. Because sometimes we can also find out that when we are having some cough or cold and there is blockage in the nasal region, then we are not able to taste the food properly. The reason is that at that time only tongue is able to take the sense the taste of the food. Nose, the receptors present in the nose, which are called olfactory, they are not able to sense the taste. So that is why we don't have that good taste at that time. Now regarding the functions of the tongue, its basic function is that it helps to taste the food, but other than that it helps in chewing the food by keeping the food particles in between the teeth for mastication or grinding, and it also helps in the swallowing of the food at the back of the tongue. When after the chewing, tongue helps the food to enter in to pass into the pharynx region, from where it enters into the food pipe. It also helps us in speaking and obviously tasting the food. There are different papillae which contains taste bud. Here one structure of the papillae is shown, and you can see that there are taste cells which are present here, and these taste cells, they help in identification of the different kind of taste which are there in the food. Now next part is teeth. There are the teeth in human beings. They are of following types. First is, we use the term diaphyodont. Diaphyodont means our teeth, they come in the set of two. Like first we have milk teeth and later on we have permanent teeth. So they come in the set of two. That is why they are called as diaphyodont. Second down is thecodont. That means tooth are deeply embedded in the jaw bones and they are tightly fixed. And third is heterodont. That is, we have different kinds of teeth. Like we can see here, there are incisors, premolars, molars, canine teeth. There are different four kinds of teeth. Now, what are these? First are incisors. These are the teeth which are present in the front area. You can see here, these are incisors. They are also called as cutting teeth because they help us to cut the food. Then are the canine teeth. These are quite pointed. These are little bit pointed and are fairly well developed in the carnivorous animals. These are well adapted to tear the flesh. So they are also cutting and tearing teeth. Then there are premolar and then is molar teeth. These teeth are used for crushing the food and mastication of the food. They help in properly grinding the food. So these teeth are helpful in the totally the breaking up and grinding of the food, which is helpful in the digestion of the food. Then next is the feature of teeth. Now how many teeth do we have? Milk teeth or deciduous teeth. Milk teeth, they fall after a certain age, so they are called as deciduous teeth. They are 20 in number. While the permanent teeth, they are 32 in number. They are found in the adults. After the milk teeth, after the milk teeth, first set of the teeth, they are the milk teeth. After them, we have got the permanent teeth. They are maximum 32 in number in a person. And there is one concept of dental formula. That we denote the number of teeth by a certain formula. This is called as dental formula. For milk teeth, it is 212 by 212. This is for one side, this is for another side. And into 2, that is one for lower jaw and one for upper jaw. So these are total of 20. Now the milk teeth, why do we write 212? Here, first two, this refers to the incisors. That is, in one half of the teeth, there are two incisors, then one canine teeth and two molar teeth. There are no premolars in the milk teeth. So, they are forming five teeth towards this region, five towards this region, and same is 5 towards this region of the upper jaw and 5 towards this region. That make up 20 teeth. Then regarding the permanent teeth, they have two incisors, one canine teeth, two premolar and three molar teeth in one side of the jaw. Either it may be lower jaw or upper jaw. And on the other side also, same number of teeth are there. And multiply by 2 due to the upper and lower jaw, they form 32 teeth. So in this way, total number of 32 teeth are present in the permanent set of humans. So I hope you are clear about the dental formula. This is important concept. Now what are the structure of teeth? There are different regions of the tooth. When we study the structure of tooth, we find that there are different regions in the tooth. First part is the crown region. This is the above projected part of the teeth, which we can see. And next is the neck region. This region is surrounded by the gums. They surround this region and we are not able to see this part. This region is called as neck. Then the root part. Third part is the root part. This part is deeply embedded in the bone. There is jaw bone. It is embedded in the bone. So we are not able to see this part. We are able to see only the crown portion of the teeth. Now regarding the different layers of the teeth. First layer is the outermost layer that you can see here in white color. This is called as enamel. Enamel is the hardest substance of the body. This is an important question. That which is the hardest substance of the body, that is the enamel. Then is dentin. Next to the enamel layer, there is dentin that forms the major part of the tooth. And it covers the pulp region. This region is the pulp region. This is rich in nerves and blood vessels. And this part is sensitive. Suppose one person is having cavity in the teeth, So when the cavity develops in enamel or dentine region, that person is not able to identify it, not able to sense it. But when it reaches the pulp region, there are the nerves which are present. So that person can feel the sense, they can feel the pain in the teeth. Now what is the function of the teeth? That helps in the mastication or chewing of the food properly, which aids in the process of digestion. So this was regarding the two parts which we studied about the buccal cavity, tongue and teeth. In next part of the video, we shall be studying about the pharynx region, and then we'll be completing about the buccopharyngeal cavity. Thank you.